Hello, my friends, and welcome to a brand new project. One in which is a very obscure game, which never has been brought over here. This is called Cave Noire, brought to us by Konami of 1991. Now, from what I've read about this game, it is a roguelike. And we are going to actually dive into this because it's a roguelike. So, let's get into this, shall we? By the way, this is fan translated, by the way. Had this game for quite a while. So, this is basically one of the two games I'm doing through the LP to the death pile. So we're getting into this thing. So when we go to config, you can rename, you can end, or you can data wipe. And somehow this reminds me of Skate or Die. The Goat Master reminded me of Lester. So basically, this is all you're going to be doing. This is most of what this game really is. Like I said, it's a roguelike, so therefore there are 9 levels. And we're just gonna simply just go through each of these quests. These 1, 2, 3, 4 quests. So you have your first quest, and then it can go up to as high as 9, as far as the level's concerned, but we're just gonna see how deep we can go with this. Quest number 1 is we slay 3 monsters. Great, we got a character by the name of Pentaro. Lovely. So, as you can tell, win battle just like that. So we find a horn. Mind you, it's a random generated dungeon that we go into. Mm-hmm. So basically, you have to work the field to your advantage. We slew three monsters. Three crabs. So this way, the more you do, the more you can switch it around. So this can be quest 1, this can be quest 2, that can be quest 3, that can be quest 4. So depending on which you may want to go for. Find 2 gold. So a healing potion, a lamp, antidote, and invis. Okay. So we simply have to find ourselves that's basically all this game is, really. Find one orb. It really is what it is. There's really no story involved, just You just go through these four dungeons as they are randomly generated. And the more you go, or the more deeper you go, the more you're pressing your luck, actually. So this is all you're really doing. Found the orb. Now we just get the hell up out of here. And then there's quest 4, which is this. Rescue one fairy. Ooh, a key, a cloak, fireball, and a heal potion. Lamplit. The deeper you go, the more dangerous it gets. Thank you. This isn't much of a game, to be honest. It's basically all you're doing is going through a dungeon, randomly generated, mind you. And as I said, this game is really RNG. There you go. We found a fairy. Hello, Fog of War. As you can tell, each of these quests just repeats itself. Ooh, a key on the fly. Nice. Trust me, it's a very short project if you really think about it. And I don't think you level in this game. You don't. You really don't. You just basically... You just keep doing the same thing until basically it gets to a higher level, like level 9. So, my secondary project is Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories, the PS2 version. Which will be a lot longer than this game. I guess this could be really a Chest of Obscurity video. Think about it. Magic sword! I guess for its time, a roguelike like this, coming from Konami? Yeah, that's a rarity. That's a Minotaur. Tarant. Minotaur. So Minotaurs and Tarants. I guess for what it's worth, you know. It's a bit of a time waster if you really think about it. Too bad you don't keep any of the weapons or items. From each dungeon, you're just going from here. This is what you're gonna start off with. Your job, find all this. You can also see how deep this actually goes. Oh. I mean, really, it's pretty interesting that all you're doing is just going through these random dungeons in a skate or die manner. And you know what? This is the first time I've ever actually done a game. Oof. That'll just be part of the Chest of Obscurity. And the first one for 2002. That's the funny thing. Fog of War again. Magic sword. This is just interesting as all get out. So fighting is an option in this game, as you can tell. Fight. That magic sword helps. Wooden shield. Bye. Hmm. two orbs. I feel I'm gonna play up to like level 2 and then just call it a video. Because this is all this game really is. You're going through a randomly generated dungeon. Just for this one objective. This is like the shortest game ever known, because you're just doing this, like, what, 9 times? Antidote. I bet you this was Konami's answer to say, dungeon crawling. It's like, well, we can do dungeon crawling too. That's why I like to believe that, you know, old school Konami used to be more innovative at the time. Much more than what they've been doing now. Which they turn into pachinko. But yet what they did, legacy still lives on. For what this game is worth, actually, this is one of those games you would probably see yourself playing if you were going on a long road trip. Oh, by the way, you can switch your character from male to female if you want. I mean, we're going to give this character a proper name. Well, this is the name you should give him. Vic Viper. Think much better than Pintar. So I think this will be the last one I can say. We'll just be working. That's nice. The fairy just poofs out any enemy in existence. Like, I like that. I mean, that's all you're doing. Sure, let's poof that thing out of existence. So, yeah, this pretty much is the whole game as you see fit. A roguelike which pretty much you can see yourself playing if you were around like 8 or 9. That's when you would grow a proper taste into video games. 8 or 9, possibly 10. So, for a roguelike, this wasn't bad for Game Boy standards. I mean, there isn't much I can really say about this game except if it's worth your time in playing through it, then maybe you could challenge yourself and to say, oh, why don't you go higher? Let's say, well, the only way you can go higher is you would have to beat the current floor. And as I said, the highest you can go is level 9, which is the hardest. And it's going to be the same thing. You're going to have to save fairies, gather money, get orbs, kill monsters. The standard fare for all who wants to be a budding young adventurer. I guess this will be it for the Chest of Obscurity then, because that's what this really is. It's not really like a... It's not really much to say, except this one video kind of explains the whole game in a nutshell. So until next when I do Kingdom Hearts, Rechain of Memory? Yeah. Rechain of Memories. Let me try to say that again. The next time our official Let's Play will be that of Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memories for the PlayStation 2. Okay? So stay tuned when we get into that. Until next time, I've been your friendly neighborhood Tenkaichi. And this was Cave Noire for the Game Boy, brought to us by Konami of 1991. So, see you next time for more great content. Ciao for now.